Michael, I'm here to go to Trav's. Thank you. Tent pegs on the mat. Gun level, straight out the box, out of the car. What else we got new? Hornady match grade 140 grain. So today is more about, and the target will be low, so I'll be shooting from low to low, put less stress, won't be shooting up as much, be able to get that in, have the gun more level. So anyhow, so today is more about re-zeroing, because unless I shoot worse, this is what I'm going to be doing from now on, the ELD. So let's get this together. We're in a bit of a, not a hurry, but we got to be a little bit quicker today. So, okay. So because I was late today, I only get to fire two rounds or two groups, and I've done it. I think they were both under one M.O.A. I got everything right. My ballistic, my wind meter, all my angles, all my conditions, right? And over 100 yards, it's not that big of a deal. But you still got to pull the trigger. You still got to set up behind the gun. So, I'm here, I'm looking at them, and they're pretty. As you saw from before, the target's lower to the ground. I'm not shooting up, putting a lot of pressure on my back. You know, when I start shooting longer at Northeast Texas Tactical, we're going to be shooting down anyway. The mat, I can push up against it and it's not pushing. Dug little holes, so that little bit of offset sets up for the bubble. Everything's good. So let's have a look. I get to see the second. I just got a text message from Trav. I get to shoot my next 10. Okay. So I'm always telling clients, good shots can create bad shots. You get that little cocky and try and hit the ball further, stuff like that. Wasn't as happy with, and my ears are just ringing like crazy. I'm such an idiot. It's so beautiful out here. Just so you know what it looks like. It goes down that way where I shoot pigs. That way where I shoot squirrels. There's a creek that runs there. Oh, it's so nice. So nice. Anyhow, not terrible. I know one of them, just looking right here, I know one of them's definitely not under one MOA. I think the other one is, oh, that earringing thing is really bad. And I did, as I said before, I suffer from tinnitus all the time. Not as bad as this. This was stupid. Oh God. I was like, literally thinking to myself, what the hell happened? Why was that so loud? New ammunition, don't know how loud it's gonna be. Like 150 grains of powder in a, yeah, it would have blown my gun up. No, that was stupid. Anyhow, looking, one's gonna squeeze under, I think. One is gonna be about 1.2, 1.3. Well, let's go and find out. Okay, yeah, I was right. One was under and one was 1.2. Anyhow, that sucks, I didn't go 4 for 4. Oh, my ears are still ringing. Idiot. Anyhow, question of the day. Question of the day. I don't want it to be political. I don't want it to be anything like that. I don't want it to be fun. For you non-shooters, and as I said, this gun that I'm currently shooting with, that one right there, will never shoot at an animal. So that's a target gun. Hunters, get away from me. Get away from me. Is that just hanging from my hat? That's stupid. Anyhow, hunters, do you target shoot? As in, hit gongs, like go out just to do that. Not to practice for hunting, just because target shooting is fun, calling wind and stuff like that. And I haven't done over 100 yet, but this is what this is for. I want to hit a mile with this gun. So, target shooters, do you or have you ever hunted? Regardless of what with, have you ever hunted? I think that's a good question. Some people love to shoot, but have an issue with the harvesting of animals. Some people who hunt do not care and just want to hit the animal. Okay, as long as you're good enough to do that, I don't have a problem with that. So, hunters, do you shoot for shooting's sake? Target shooters, have you ever hunted? Do you have a problem with it? That's the question of the day. Okay, thanks a lot. Okay, so, that's my new bag, my new rear bag. It's a single stretch, so if I squeeze like this, it doesn't go this way as much. It's supposed to just go this way or fall like this. It's got a good shape, so it sits there, the gun sits on there pretty good, and it's got little plastic M&Ms in it. I like it. I opened it, I wanted to see it, and I lost a bunch of them. Not enough to matter, but anyway. My Kestrel is working. It was me. I put in a couple of numbers that were incorrect, and it made it out. So, I didn't change my zero. I think I have to move up like one MOA. That's it. And so the difference between 125 and 140 grain is not that big of a point of impact change. So I'm happy with that. I was both sides of it. So that's still me. That is me. Even though it was three groups inside of one MOA, that the side to side is me. I do have to get a new bipod, but not yet. I've bought four so far and sent three back, so got rid of three. So that is an issue. I got 10 pegs from Cabela's. I'm always at Cabela's. I got 10 pegs for the mat, so the mat's all down. The ammunition, Hornady 140s, obviously much better than Winchester 125 grain range. Not taking anything away from that, they're in between $12 and $15 a box. It's my fault for spending $12 and $15 a box for ammunition. That 20 was 120 through the barrel. So when I get home this afternoon, I'm going to pull my snake through it, do some bit of cleaning. There's a lot of, obviously, uproar. Second question of the day, how often do you clean your barrel? You know, I've watched videos where guys go, got to clean, you know, got to take your bolt apart and do it. I'm looking in my bolt here and nope. Might take a little brush to the bolt face, but other than that, nothing. So, you know, do you do that? How often do you pull a snake through the barrel? So, I am excited though. Sounds like it, right? I'm very, very excited. Did I think I would get under 1 MOA the first time I went there? And I say that term a lot, 1 MOA, 1 MOA, 1 MOA. Well, when I get to, you know, when the range is opened, I can't get on the 1500 range until I prove I can get under one. So, safety issue. So, gotta do it, right? 10 inches at 1000, 15 inches at 1500, 17.62 inches at a mile. I don't mess around with goals. I hit goals. Okay, so, oh man. So stupid. Everything's right and tight with this. My gun's right here, by the way. Oops, still hooked up. There we go. Bolts out, everything's good. Right. Everything's right and tight with that. Anything that happens from now on is me. By the way, I'm bald. Shave smooth. Everything from now on is me and wind. And wind calling, whoever's going to be calling my wind at that point. So more dry firing, feeling better, not 100% behind the gun. That's why I'm getting a little bit of this, both sides of that target. I might take the other 20 that I have next time I'm here and do a tall target test. Just get better, watch more videos. Tibosaurus Rex had some interesting videos over the last week, so that's it. I think we're done. I'd love to just sit out here for a little bit. It's 20 to 11, but I got a dentist appointment and a doctor appointment this afternoon, so which I got to get to. I'm gonna turn the music up because my ears are ringing. Okay. Play the sounds.